Here's something I always wanted. Is it a pizza? No, I've had pizzas before. This is a grow light. This is a 50-watt LED grow light. Let's look at some of the specs first of it. This is the company name, Shengsite, if I pronounce that correctly. 50-watt panel, okay? 50 watts, 300 milliamps, 50,000-hour life, guaranteed for 2 years. The area it covers, it says, is 1.5 square meters. And I did a little testing with my late meter here, and I seem to agree with that idea that there's about a 3 foot square, okay? And of course, that's going to change to some degree on how high you have it from your plants or how low, okay? But let's look at the other things. It's made out of plastic. It weighs about a kilogram. This little holder I had to put on, very easy to put on. You need a small Phillips screwdriver. And what you do is you put the screw through here, then you put a washer, then you put the hanger, then you put the nut, and then you tighten it. Now, it's important that the washer is next to this, because that's going to protect the plastic from that metal nut. So make sure you do it in that order. It wants, since it weighs a kilogram or about a half a pound, it wants you to hang it on something that will hold at least 10 times that weight. In other words, something that will hold a 10-pound weight. And you are going to add the cord here. The cord is nice in that it fits in only one way. Okay, you can't fit it in the opposite way. LEDs are polarized, so you definitely want to be able to have the current going through them the same way every time. Okay. Let's look at some of the other information here before we go inside, and I'm actually going to light this up for you. It has these little reflective condenser cups in it that are 60 degrees, and that's to help capture some more of the light. You're going to see me talk about additional reflectors, and all people that use these types of light will put them in a reflective light tent, because you just don't want to waste the light, okay? This has a 2-year warranty. That's really nice. Widely used in greenhouse plant factories, cultivation, flower breeding, indoor gardens, soluble breeding. I think that means that they're talking about hydroponics there. We have a little translation problems here. Pipeline cultivation, farm, potted plants, tissue culture, suitable for bananas, flowers, tobacco, seaweed, green peppers, eggplants, bitter gourds, tomatoes, grapes, lettuce, and other herbs. It's interesting that they say seaweed and algae, because believe it or not, that's a growing industry, and sometimes for certain things you need to have a supply of algae to feed certain aquarium fishes and things like that, for tissue culture and other things, or using regular soil or hydroponics. This isn't waterproof, so we're not going to use it outdoors, okay? It also wants you to put it away from heat. In other words, sometimes with hydroponics, sometimes using a light, I might decide that I'm going to set this up in another room during the winter in Maine here. It's going to get cold. Well, I'm going to have to provide additional heat. Well, I don't want to set the heater up by the lamp. And usually plants prefer heat from the bottom anyway. So you're going to have the heat coming up from the bottom. And if you use some other type of heater, you're not going to have the heater blow directly on the light, okay? It's nice here that has a temperature range of minus 20 degrees to 40 degrees. That's Celsius, but that's quite a range. 45% to 90% relative humidity. And again, when we talk about putting these in a tent, especially if we're doing hydroponics, we get a high relative humidity. And in some cases, that we'll actually need fans to remove some of that moisture. And not as much with a light like this, but with the high intensity halogen type lights, they get very hot and we need to remove heat. Okay, it's interesting here that it says when it thunders, please cut off the power supply. So I would suggest, based on that recommendation of what I understand about solid state electronics and computers, this is after all a solid state light, I would use a power surge protector, a power strip that has the breaker in it, and make sure it's rated for the 50 watts, which isn't going to be too much of a problem. That isn't that high. Now, I have a really high quality light meter, and I just kind of use this in the house to turn the lights out, and I use this to kind of confirm, and I would agree that it has this 1.5 square meter area, or 3 square feet. And again, it's going to be much more efficient if we can capture some of the stray light and use that. So we're going to construct something for that. So let's go inside. We're going to turn the light on, and you're going to get a chance to look at it and see what it does. And then, of course, then the actual thing will be put in operation, and we'll have follow-up videos that will show how well my plants are growing. So that should be exciting. Now, I like this idea because I've always wanted to do this. I always wanted to have indoor growing. I have some plants and pots that I could bring in the house. We're getting to fall in Maine, and the leaves are starting to change, believe it or not. So some of the plants I can bring in and keep them growing for the winter. Also, this would be great to grow the small microgreens with, and things like that. We have parrots, as you kind of see some cages when I'm in there. And not that microgreens aren't great for people too, but the parrots enjoy them too. And this would be a way to provide our own source of greens that we grow ourselves for them. So, as I say, I'm very excited to put this in use and get it going and get some experience with using it. Well, here we are with our first setup testing. Just, I've got the light just suspended up to get an idea of it here. We have red and we have blue LEDs, okay? Okay, now if I look down at the pattern on my floor, these blocks are approximately one square foot. So at this height, which is approximately at 5'6", I see a pattern of 3x3 really illuminated well. And of course, there is more light around that. Now, anyone that works with LED lights knows that you can't waste light. In other words, if I had a plant here, even if I had it at this level, okay, even if it was a foot away, they mention some plants would be closer than other plants, right? That we can't have all this wasted light going out on the sides. So generally, LED grow lights, they put in reflector tents. What I'm going to use to make this reflector tent is a car windshield. This is from the Dollar Tree. This is a dollar. I bought two of these, and what I'm going to do is make a little tent out of these, and I'm going to put them around this light so that none of the lights get wasted. See, now the light, instead of just going off over here, is going to be bounced back to my plant. But it's important to capture all the light possible from these lights, from any light really, whether they use the high intensity halogen bulbs, fluorescent bulbs, mixture of fluorescent and incandescent they used to use once, or LED bulbs. It's very important to try to capture as much light. So I would suggest that you either purchase or think about constructing your own light tent. Now the advantage to these are, this is 50 watts, so it's not going to get as hot as some of the conventional, well, definitely not as hot as the high pressure sodium type lights that they use, halogen type lights. So we're not going to have the heat problem much, but we're definitely going to have to capture as much light as we can to bring down on our plant. So this looks very interesting. Of course, the proof is in the pudding. What we're going to do is set it up, and we're going to try growing some things with it. And we'll see exactly how well it performs in actual use.